Facebook's VP, Andrew Bosworth, sat down together with CEO Mark Zuckerberg, who owns Facebook itself. And they answered some questions about a range of VR and AR topics. But the most interesting question they were asked was about the future of virtual reality. And to be specific, the future of neural interfaces. Now, a neural interface is basically what we see in animes like Sword Art Online, where we put on a virtual reality headset, but instead of having to use the controllers, we can just think of walking or doing a certain action, and the headset itself will then read the signals that are coming from our brain and send them directly into the game. Now, Mark Zuckerberg and Andrew Bosworth were asked about their thoughts of the future of virtual reality and how close they are to making a neural interface. And they answered the following. We have, for a very long time back, had a very strong vision of neural interfaces, and because of this, to have more fluid controls. We've invested in this. And Mark Zuckerberg answered the following. Well, whenever you're designing a new platform, I think of one of the most important aspects of it is input. I think in a lot of ways, how you can control it is the most defining aspect of a platform. And a lot of people think about AR and VR as a sort of what's the output, like what do I see, and not really think about the input. And it's a very interesting statement that he makes, because most people, when they put on a virtual reality headset, now they will just see on the screen how good something looks or not. But the input is a very key factor as well. Like for example, good controllers. What Mark Zuckerberg also said is that the bigger thing that defines PCs is that you have a keyboard and mouse. For phones, you have, for example, a multi-touch and swipe input. So it depends from device to device what kind of input you have. And that's true. At the PC, the best input is going to be your keyboard and your mouse to have the quickest interface. And on your phone, the easiest way is to do it through a touchscreen. But for virtual reality, there's multiple options. And until now, we've been using normal controllers to find our way through virtual reality. But then Mark Zuckerberg finally answered that question about neural interfaces as follows. What are you going to use to control this natural interface around AR and VR? Our view is that it's going to be somewhat of a combination of things. And that's such an important key factor, because this means that they're really working on it. And he sees it more as a combination, where we might still have controllers using our hands like hand input, but that the headset itself can still actually read the signals that are coming from our brain and then translate it into the game itself. He also compared a couple of different inputs that could have been used for virtual reality. Like for example, voice assistants. It sure would be amazing that we could just say, walk forward, walk back, walk left, walk right. But the thing is that this is not really immersive. Even the input we have right now with controllers will be more immersive than that, because we actually have to make the movements ourselves. And on top of that, there's also going to be a huge privacy issue, because you might not always want that the people next to you hear what you're actually doing. But then Mark Zuckerberg also noticed how the controllers right now are also going to have a limited use, because we have the space around us. Not all of us have a huge castle to play virtual reality in. And that means that if we want to walk forward or backwards in a game, eventually we will hit against a wall. And that's why it's so important to also find other ways to have virtual reality input. But then an insane twist came, where Mark Zuckerberg said the following. In some ways, the holy grail of all of this is neural interface, where you basically just think something and your mind kind of tells the computer how you want it to go, and that works. So he's saying right now that he also thinks that the future input of virtual reality will be a neural interface, just like we see in Sword Art Online. And this would just be amazing. And it doesn't stop there. He even says that there's a bunch of research that they and others are doing into this. And that's amazing. But he also said that a lot of people are thinking about neural interfaces in a different way. It's not necessarily how can we understand what you're thinking, but it's not actually about that. But what you're trying to do is that you give a person the ability to have their brain send signals to the rest of the body and the headset about how this works. And we already have that system inside our bodies, which are called motor neurons. The only thing that we still need is a virtual reality headset that reads these movements. And the best thing is that Mark Zuckerberg said all of these things himself. So he knows how important neural interfaces are. And it's so amazing that one of the biggest virtual reality companies actually has a view that neural interfaces is the future. And the last thing he said in his interview, that this is perhaps one of their more ambitious products that they have going on, but that he thinks it's really promising long term, and that the team is making great progress towards it already. Now, when I heard these things, I couldn't be more happy. It has always been a dream to have a neural interface like Sword Art Online in virtual reality. And it could directly also solve the motion problem of where we are limited with the space around us.